component. Okay? So right now, it's just like, think about it, it's just like a PC, like a computer. Of course, it has the power supply, which you connect to give the power. It has the flash, which holds the operating system. Normally, you know, when you install a Windows operating system on your computer, you need to give C drive, D drive, something like that, right? So basically, your operating system is stored in the, for the Windows operating system stored in the C drive, or but the window, for the Cisco router operating system stored in the flash. Then there is a boot ROM. Then there is a RAM, which is like where the configuration is stored. CPU as well. These are the different components of the router. There are other components as well. We'll see one by one. So first of all, okay, this is important, guys. How the router is actually boot up. First, the router boots up, bring up router during installation. What are different components? Post check, basic functionality of the interfaces, ROM monitor mode, manufacturing, testing, and troubleshooting. You know, if your window is corrupting, sometimes you go into the C mode, or initially you change the sequence of the machine or computer from the D drive to C drive, or USB, or maybe CD-ROM, something like that. Okay, then manufacturing, testing, and troubleshooting. Mini iOS loads Cisco iOS into the flash. RAM holds the packet, buffer, routing table, store the running configuration. And then it is even, it's not a permanent storage actually, because it depends on the RAM. And once the router is stored in the flash, yes, component view. ROM start maintain the router. These are the another components. For example, ROM, what the ROM is doing, starts maintain the router. Flash memory holds the Cisco iOS, not erased when the router is reloaded. NVRAM holds router switch configuration, not erased when the... So that is the difference between NVRAM and RAM. RAM, whatever it is, if the router is reloaded, it will be erased. Okay? Sometimes if your computer is hanged up, somebody advises you, please. Okay? So when the NVRAM, it does not erase when even the router is reloaded, whatever is saved there is there. Configuration register value now control how the router boots up. Okay, I'll show you the virtual configuration here. The boot sequence, what is the, how the router boots? The boot sequence point of view, it is very critical to understand. Router perform post. Post means power on self test. That power is there. Then bootstrap look for the load the Cisco iOS. If the Cisco iOS is there, it loads that. iOS software look for the valid configuration file. If the valid configuration file is the, and the valid configuration file stored in the startup configuration file in the NVRAM, if the startup configuration file is not there, router will start with the setup. Okay, what is the setup mode?
First
time when you log into the device, you can run this setup mode at any time. You see, the setup mode is like a dialogue mode, which is asking you step by step, do you want to configure? We say yes. Do you want to do basic management? Say yes or no, something like that. Okay. And so many like a dialog box which guide you that, okay, what you want to do with a router or a switch. So set a box in it. So basically, important thing is in the router boot sequence, the router performs the post. Okay. Post mean power on self test. Okay, boot sequence. Router perform the post. Then bootstrap look for the load to iOS. The iOS software look for the valid configuration file. And if the startup file is there in the NVRAM, it load it. If it's not fine, it will run the startup setup wizard. Now, what is the configuration register value? Configuration register value is 16-bit software written into the NVRAM, load from the flash, look for the startup configuration. So that is why default behavior of the, we will see the value actually. If you look at the, this is the router, right? If I do, show version. You see this value, configuration register value, 2102, okay? It's a 16-bit software written into the NVRAM, load from the flash memory, the valid basically, by default, the configuration is 2102. The functionality of this, if you have 2102 value, it will actually load from a flash menu and look for the startup configuration. That is the default behavior it has. So, for example, if I go to the config mode and I say config registered value 0 into 2100, let's say I just change it. If I change it, reload. So what I have done, I have changed the configuration registered value. Now what happens, you see the router, it goes into the ROM monitor mode. You see the notice the difference? I just changed the configuration registered value from default 2102, which tells the router, load from the flash memory and look for the startup config. That's the default behavior. If I want to change the default behavior due to some troubleshooting reason, I have just instructed my router that configuration register value change anytime 2102 to 2100. Okay? Now when I reload the box, you can see it's going into the ROM monitor mode. And ROM monitor mode is used for some kind of troubleshooting purpose. If the IRS is corrupted, if due to any reason configuration file is not there, most likely if the password you change. Password reset sometime. Let me see, reset. Again, it's reset. Now, if I want to change it back, look, you see, now it is looking for the flash. This is operating system is loaded. Because operating system in the router, it is compressed. It is decompressing the image, and now it looks for the valid configuration. That is a default behavior. Okay? So these are the values you can see, the configuration registered value. The default are, okay, 2102. That's the default one. It might be an interview or exam question, the default register value of the router. If you have 2102, to this 2102, see that the bits are on or off in the decimal or hexadecimal. You see that why 2102 is the value. It tells the router to load from the flash memory and look for the startup configuration. Okay? If you want to use a different combination, you can apply these and router will behave accordingly. Mostly used for the troubleshooting purpose. Okay.